And like, I'm a student studying in SCU. I'm doing my PhD in Center for Regional Studies. My name is Sanjay. I work for Student Federation of India. I'm like, as many of us are aware, like, after Roy's death, the movement that we have been doing has been continuing. And we had clearly stated university administration that till APARA, I mean, till the judicial inquiry is over and something has come out with regard to SCST atrocity case that has been filed on Professor APARA, who is the Vice Chancellor, then only APARA can enter. Like, if he is not found guilty, then only he can enter into campus. We agreed to the administration when we had talks with the administration, with the acting Vice Chancellor Pere Swami and other officials. We clearly stated them. And based on that only, the campus has come to, classes have been resumed and activities are going on the campus. Campus was very peaceful. But all of a sudden, APARA with ill intentions, mobilizing some of the faculties, everything with a plan, he suddenly entered into the campus to provoke the students. So we went to question that why police have not arrested APARA till now when an SCST atrocity case has been booked on him. So when we went to do that, by the time APARA was already with the AVP students of this campus, whom we had mobilized, and in clearly he had a list of tasks in a written document or a mail which has been circulated among many faculty and AVP students, saying that they should come and they should be with him in his Vice Chancellor's guest house. A Vice Chancellor cannot have all the students in his guest house for a meeting or anything. Like, he has an official building for this purpose, that is administrative block. And he came and he sent a mail at 9:30 saying that he is assuming the charges and he was with all these AVP students. When we went to protest that one, why he is not arrested, the AVP people started a scuffle and they started breaking all the furniture or whatever were in the VC lodge. And later police came and we were clearly demanding from the police saying that APARA should be arrested or he shouldn't be on the campus till the inquiry of the judicial committee is over. But police have actually acted and they wanted to remove us from there, and we clearly stated that this is a university and we have a right to protest. But police, brutally, they have lathi charged each one, every one of us, especially all the students who
were there. You also attacked?
Yeah.
Can you show where it is?
Yes, I was attacked and I had a...
Okay. It was hidden, yesterday they hit you, police has hit you.
Yesterday police have hit me. And if you go by that, it's not just few students, it's nearly some 50 to 60 students out of all the 200 plus students who have been there. Everybody has been brutally injured, especially girls. And the Hyderabad Commissionate or the Telangana Police did not even have minimum courtesy to deploy women police officers to actually deal with the girls. They were actually, even the Karthikeya, who is the DCP of Telangana state, has actually manhandled so many women students and others. Brutally, they were beaten and they were taken to police stations. Now, as of now, we do not know where they are or what cases they are going to file on them or what they are going to do to the students. They are not giving any information. And I seriously condemn this act. And we appeal to all the progressive sections to show solidarity, to stop this inhuman violation of human rights or atrocity on the Dalit students in university campuses.